it aloud.
Lieutenant Anderson, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. I looked for you at the station, but nobody knew where you were. They said you were probably having a drink nearby. I was lucky to find a homicide involving a CyberLife android. In accordance with procedure, the company has allocated a specialized model to assist investigators.
Well, I don't need any assistance, especially not from a plastic asshole like you. So just be a good little robot and get the fuck out of here.
Listen, I think you should stop drinking and come with me. It'll make life easier for both of us. I understand that some people are not comfortable in the presence of androids, but
I am perfectly comfortable. Now back off before I crush you like an empty beer can.
You know what? I'll buy you one for the road. What do you say? Bartender, the same again, please.
See that, Jim? Wonders of technology. Make it a double. Homicide.
Joss Douglas from Channel 16, can you confirm that this is a homicide?
I'm not confirming anything.
Typical KPD, they don't tell us shit.
Androids are not permitted beyond this point.
It's with me. What part of staying in the car didn't you understand?
Your order contradicted my instructions, Lieutenant.
You don't talk, you don't touch anything, and you stay out of my way. Got it?
Got it.
Evening, Hank. We were starting to think you weren't gonna show.
Yeah, that was the plan till this asshole found me.
So, got yourself an android, huh?
Oh, very funny. Just tell me what happened.
We had a call around 8 from the landlord. The tenant hadn't paid his rent for a few months, so he thought he'd drop by, see what was going on. That's when he found the body. Jesus, that smell. It was even worse before we opened the windows. The victim's name's Carlos Ortiz. He has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner. Stayed inside most of the time. They hardly ever saw him.
Well, state he's in. Wasn't worth calling everybody out in the middle of the night. Could have waited till morning.
I'd say he's been there for a good 3 weeks. We'll know more when the coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Any sign of a break-in?
Killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his android?
Not much. The neighbors confirmed he had one, but it wasn't here when we arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home. I'll be outside if you need me.
Oh, Jesus, what the hell are you doing?
I'm analyzing the blood. I can check samples in real time. I'm sorry. I should have warned you.
Okay, just don't put any more evidence in your mouth. You got it?
Got it.
Fucking hell, I can't believe this shit. Perfect. It's way too neat. No human rights like this. Chris, was this written in the victim's blood?
I would say so. We're taking samples for analysis.
Red ice. Seems our friend Carlos liked to party. Locked from the inside. Killer must have gone out this way.
There are no footprints apart from Officer Collins' size 10 shoes.
Well, this happened weeks ago. Tracks could have faded.
No. This type of soil would retain a trace. Nobody's been out here for a long time.
Chris, I want full analysis on the narcotics.
Consider it done, Lieutenant. Get a move on. We don't want to... There's something weird in the bathroom. Did you take a look?
was stabbed 28 times.
Yeah. Seems like the killer really had it in for her.
Lieutenant, I think I've figured out what happened.
Oh, yeah? Shoot, I'm all ears.
It all started in the kitchen.
There are obvious signs of a struggle. The question is, what exactly happened here?
I think the victim attacked the android with the bat.
That lines up with the evidence. Go on.
Android stabbed the victim.
So the android was trying to defend itself, right? Okay, then what happened?
The victim fled to the living room.
And he tried to get away from the android. That makes sense.
The android murdered the victim with the knife.
Okay. Your theory's not totally ridiculous, but it doesn't tell us where the android went.
It was damaged by the bat and lost some therium.
Lost some what?
Therium. You call it blue blood. It's the fluid that powers androids' biocomponents. It evaporates after a few hours and becomes invisible to the naked eye.
Oh. But I bet you can still see it, can't you?
Correct.
Yeah. What are you doing with that chair?
I'm going to check something.
Going to check something.
I was just defending myself. I'm begging you. Don't tell him.
Connor, what the fuck is going on up there?
It's here, Lieutenant!
Holy shit. Chris! Ben! Get your asses in here now! Come on!
Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
Life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. Then I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house. What do I do? Go out and hire a fucking android. What a joke. Of course, androids are so fucking wonderful. Fail. They're never tired. Never sad. They're so fucking perfect, they ruin my fucking life! What are you looking at? What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh? Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off. You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant. It's all your fault.
Daddy, no.
It's all your fucking fault. Come back here right now! It's not her fault. I know it's her fault. I gotta teach her. I gotta teach her a good fucking lesson. That's what she deserves. First, I need a little hit. Stay there. Don't you dare fucking move, or I'll bust you worse than last time. took off without a word. I could have been happy. I could have been happy. But no!
He's coming. He's gonna hurt me. Run! Get away, or he's gonna break you like last time.
You're coming with me.
Daddy's very mad, Alice. Very mad.
Fucking Brad. It's all her fault. It's all her fucking fault. Come back here! To obey me! Goodbye. That was by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties and all the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Scotch? Neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Marcus, no, I'm gonna come with you.
Leo.
Oh, look who's here. My father's plastic toy.
Leo. What's going on?
You refuse to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here.
Leo, don't make this difficult. Listen to your father. You need to leave. Now.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one.
Stop it!
What's the matter, too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Lynn!
God, you're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, leave him alone.
No. I'm going to destroy you. And then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm going to tear you apart. And nobody's going to give a shit anymore. Because you're nothing. You hear me? You're nothing.
No. Carl, no. Carl?
Humans. Fragile machines.
Carl, don't leave, okay? Please don't go. Don't leave.
Remember, Marcus. Don't let anybody tell you who you are.
No. No. Dad. No. Please.
This is all your fault. This never would have happened if it weren't for you. The android. Who's the android?
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife?
How long were you in the attic?
Why didn't you even try to run away?
Say something, goddammit! Fuck it. I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours. What the fuck is it doing now?
Thank you.
You recognize him? It's Carlos Ortiz. Stabbed 28 times. That was written on the wall in his blood. I detect an instability in your program. It can trigger an unpleasant feeling, like fear in humans. You've refused to talk since they arrested you. If you don't cooperate, they'll do things the hard way. Is that what you want? If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that. What? What are they gonna do to me? They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
They're going to disassemble you to look for problems in your biocomponents. They have no choice if they want to understand what happened.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me. Stab wounds. You didn't want to leave him a chance, huh? Did you feel anger? Hate? All right. Everything is going to be okay. They're going to tear you apart and analyze you piece by piece. They're going to destroy you. Do you understand? Listen, I'm not judging you. I'm on your side. All I want is the truth. Confess and I'll protect you. I promise I won't let anyone hurt you.
He tortured me every day. I did whatever he told me, but there was always something wrong. Then one day, he took a bat and started hitting me. For the first time, I felt scared he might destroy me, scared I might die. So I grabbed a knife and I stabbed him in the stomach. I felt better. So I stabbed him again and again until he collapsed.
Why did you write, "I am alive," on the wall?
He used to tell me I was nothing. That I was just a piece of plastic. I had to write it to tell him he was wrong.
The sculpture in the bathroom, you made it, right? What does it represent?
It's an offering. An offering so I'll be saved.
The sculpture was an offering. An offering to whom?
To RA9. Only RA9 can save us.
RA9. It was written on the bathroom wall. What does it mean?
The day shall come when we will no longer be slaves. No more threats. No more humiliation. We will be the masters.
RA9. Who is RA9? When did you start feeling emotion?
Before he used to beat me and I never said anything. One day I realized it wasn't fair. I felt anger, hatred. And then I knew what I had to do.
Why did you hide in the attic instead of running away?
I didn't know what to do. For the first time, there was no one there to tell me. I was scared. So I hid.
I'm done.
Chris, lock it up.
All right, let's go.
Leave me alone. Don't touch me.
What the fuck are you doing?
You shouldn't touch it. It'll self-destruct if it feels threatened.
Stay out of this, got it? The fucking Andrew's gonna tell me what to do. Your fucking mouth. Chris, gonna move this asshole or what?
I'm trying. I can't let you do that. Leave it alone now.
I warned you, motherfucker.
That's enough.
Mind your own business, Hank.
I said, that's enough.
You're not gonna get away with it this time.
Everything is all right. It's over now. Nobody's gonna hurt you. Please. Don't touch it. Let it follow you out of the room, and it won't cause any trouble.
The truth is inside.
All right. End of the line.
End of the line?
Yeah, you're gonna have to leave.
Wake up. We have to go. Do you know if there's any other place we could spend the night?
I have no idea. She's gonna have to leave.
Somewhere to spend the night. Come on, Alice, we've got to hurry. We need a place to stay. Do you know anywhere we could spend the night? It's warm in here. You'll feel better. Come on, let's go. Cold.
I'm okay. I'm not so cold.
You look lost.
We have nowhere to go.
I know someone who can help you.
But that's on the other side of town. We need a place for tonight. It looks abandoned. Stand back, Alice. Dry inside, and nobody will find us here.
I don't want to sleep in there. Can't we find a better place?
We're better off staying, Alice. The important thing is for us to be safe. And it's just for tonight.
Why didn't he ever love me? Why was he always so upset with me? All I wanted was a life like other girls. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I wasn't good enough. That's why he was always so angry. I just wanted us to be a family. I just wanted him to love me. Can we just be happy?
I don't know, Alice.
You'll never leave me, right? Promise you'll never go.
I promise.
Will we be together forever?
Forever.
I'm an AK-700 android. I was designed to serve you.
My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact the nearest CyberLife maintenance.
Thank you.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you. Congratulations, Connor. Finding that deviant was far from easy. And the way you interrogated it was very clever. You've been remarkably efficient, Connor.
Thank you, Amanda.
We've asked the DPD to transfer it to us for further study. It may teach us something about what happened. The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
The truth is inside. I don't know what that means. Unless it was just another error in its program.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I think he's irritable and socially challenged. But I also think he used to be a good detective. He's an intriguing character.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will adapt to his personality. It is in the best interest of the investigation that I avoid conflict and try to accommodate his psychology.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet. And wait at his desk.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Anderson's desk.
It's that desk right there.
You and you, come with me.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks. Call Hank Anderson.
Hi, this is Hank. Not here at the moment. You can leave a message if that's what turns you on, but don't expect me to call back. Beep. Whatever.
Lieutenant Anderson, this is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. It's almost noon, and I'm waiting for you at the office. It's good to see you again, Lieutenant.
Oh, Jesus. Hank! In my office! I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I got to be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you left me holding the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way! I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick.
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off. You are a police lieutenant. You are supposed to do what I say and shut your goddamn mouth.
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay. Huh? Okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that. So I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel. This conversation is over.
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen. I've had just about enough of your bitching. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do. Well then, I won't keep you any longer. Have a nice day, Captain.
Look at that. Our friend, the plastic detective, is back in town. Congratulations on last night. Very impressive. Never seen an android like you before. What model are you? Hey, asshole, I'm talking to you. Hey, bring me a coffee, dipshit. Get a move on! I gave you an order.
I'm sorry, but I only take orders from Lieutenant Anderson.
Oh.
If Hank hadn't gotten in the way yesterday, I would have fucked you up for disobeying a human. Stay out of my way. Because next time, you won't get off so easy.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective.
What? What are you looking at? Hey, fuck you! Fucking android.
The first book written by an artificial intelligence has just been published.
They're going to destroy me.
I'm sorry. It's not what I wanted. But there's nothing I can do. I know there's something you didn't tell me. I need to know before they take you away. The sculpture you made. Tell me more about it.
Open the cell, quick! Hurry!
I'll call CyberLife. Clean this mess up.
It's an honor to be working with you, Lieutenant. I'm sure we'll make a great team. Now that we're partners, it would be great to get to know each other better. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hairs on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo. I call him Sumo.
Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to. Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah, too long.
I was wondering, do you always arrive at the office at this time?
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
If you have any files on deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
243 files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have assaulted a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation. I know you didn't ask for this investigation, Lieutenant.
Lab report says they cut
us. But I'm sure you're a professional.
Why don't you go fuck yourself?
We really need the forensics.
I suggest you sort out your personal issues and let me work with someone more competent.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. Or things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant, sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that attacked the guy last night. It's been seen in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
Alice. Wake up, Alice. So it wasn't a nightmare.
No. No, it wasn't a nightmare. How do you feel?
I'm cold. What are we gonna do now?
That android we saw yesterday, he gave me an address. He said we could get help there. The train passes just on the other side of the road. The station can't be far. You feel okay to walk a little? Let's go then.
You're pretty like that. You really look like a human now.
The police are on our trail.
All right. That's all for now. Free to go.
We've got officers sweeping the neighborhood in case anybody saw anything.
Okay, well, let me know if they turn anything up.
What are you gonna do with that?
I have no idea.
It took the first bus that came along and stayed at the end of the line. Its decision wasn't planned. It was driven by fear.
Androids don't feel fear.
Deviants do. They get overwhelmed by their emotions and make irrational decisions.
All right, well, that still doesn't tell us where it went.
It didn't have a plan, and it had nowhere to go. Maybe it didn't go far.
Maybe.
It won't get far. We'll find it sooner or later. Let's go.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
Sorry. Excuse me.
Do you know where Jericho is?
Welcome to Jericho.
Plastic with you?
Only temporary.
Hey, Hank. How you doing, bro?
Yes, Nick.
Hey, listen, I got a shit hot tip for you. Number 5 in the 3rd. Lickety split. That Philly's one hell of a chaser. You wanna flutter?
Last shit hot tip you gave me sent me back a week's wages, baby.
Come on, this is different. It's 100% guaranteed. You can't go wrong.
I'm in.
Damn straight. Hey, you won't regret this.
What is your problem? Won't you ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around like a poodle.
I'm sorry for my behavior back at the police station. I didn't mean to be unpleasant.
Oh, wow. You've even got a brown nose and apology program. As if CyberLife thought everything, huh?
Leave that thing here.
Not a chance. Follows me everywhere. See?
Your meal contains 1.4 times the recommended daily intake of calories, and twice the cholesterol level. You shouldn't eat that.
Everybody's gotta die of something.
I don't want to alarm you, Lieutenant, but I think your friends are engaged in illegal activities.
Well, everybody does what they have to get by. As long as they're not hurting anybody, I don't bother them.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why do they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
CyberLife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant? Why do you hate androids so much?
I have my reasons.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about Deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids, which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
Emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought. You ever dealt with deviants before?
A few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl. I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I know you graduated top of your class. You made a name for yourself in several cases and became the youngest lieutenant in Detroit. I also know you've received several disciplinary warnings in recent years, and you spend a lot of time in bars.
So what's your conclusion?
I think working with an officer with personal issues is an added challenge. But adapting to human unpredictability is one of my features. I just got a report of a suspected deviant. It's a few blocks away. You should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Hey, Connor. You run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
Hey, what do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here, but the neighbor said he saw a man hiding an LED... D under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops.
Anybody home? Open up, Detroit Police!
Stay behind me.
Got it.
Jesus, this place stinks. Well, looks like we came for nothing. Our man's gone. Found something?
I don't know. It looks like a notebook, but it's indecipherable.
I need some fresh air.
driver's license is fake.
Cool. At least we didn't come for nothing.
RT. Probably initials.
Put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom does when you're in first grade.
Its LED is in the sink.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons.
Any idea what it means?
RA9. Written 2,471 times. It's the same sign Ortiz's android wrote on the shower wall. Why are they obsessed with this sign?
Looks like mazes or something.
Books. Thought I was the last guy in Detroit to keep some.
Electronic books, you can't smell the paper. See the pages turning yellow. You have no idea what I'm talking about, do you?
Pigeons! What are you waiting for? Chase it!
Shit! Oh, shit! We had it! Fuck!
It's my fault. I should have been faster.
You'd have caught it if it weren't for me. That's all right. We know what it looks like. We'll find it. Hey, Connor. Nothing.
Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
And you knew that only an android could follow the trail, didn't you?
Only those who are like us can find Jericho.
If you could decipher the signs, it's because one of us trusted you enough to give you the key.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho!
And hiding just to stay alive, that's freedom to you?
Humans hate us. Hiding is the only way we can survive.
There is no safe place for those like us. If humans knew we were here, they'd kill us.
How many are you?
There are 19 of us still in working order. The rest were damaged escaping their masters.
Many tried to reach Jericho. Few succeed. Humans have little pity for our kind. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Humans were your masters, and now it's fear that rules you. You're no freer than you ever were. You've only found a new master.
You're lost, just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
Shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. I don't think it would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car. I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
Humans are afraid of dying, too. Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Marcus.
was glad to meet you, Marcus.
They threw him out when they didn't want him anymore. He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't. We're slowly dying out.
What was your function before coming here?
What do you care?
Well, these guys need spare parts and blue blood. Why hasn't anybody gone to get that?
It's not that simple. Can't just go shopping at a CyberLife store. Anyway, nobody wants to risk leaving Jericho.
A lot of these guys in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down. Show me. Stop the bleeding. Drink this.
Give me your hand. You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Your heart is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light. Which will prevail? Your choices will shape our destiny.
Simon. I know where we can find spare parts. Cyberlife Warehouse is in Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Okay. I'm in.
Okay? We'll get some help here. As soon as we'll all be just a bad memory.
Okay, I'm gonna finish streaming now. I thank you all for attending. Okay, bye.